Hello and welcome to the sixth video of the root finding method series. In this video, we will learn about one of the most popular root finding method, which is known as Newton-Raphson method. In this method, let's say we pick an initial guess of the root at xi. We can then draw a tangent from the point on the function at xi. The next estimate of the root will then be the point where the tangent crosses the x-axis. We then repeat the process until a stopping criterion is met. We can use the Newton-Raphson formula for the next estimate of the root value. One of the main reasons for the popularity of this method is its quadratic convergence, which means that the number of significant figures of accuracy approximately doubles with each iteration. The Newton-Raphson function requires the original function, its derivative, start and end of the evaluation interval, stopping criterion, and the maximum number of iterations as arguments. Since a function can have multiple roots, we first use the incremental search to find how many roots are present. Then we provide initial guesses. If a user-specified initial guess is not available, we use the intervals obtained from the incremental search to find an initial guess for each root. In the main while loop, the root is then estimated using the Newton-Raphson formula. We compute the relative error, and if the maximum number of iterations has not reached, we assign the estimated value to x underscore r underscore old variable, and then the function value to f underscore old variable, and repeat the process until a stopping criterion is met. Let's now run the Newton-Raphson method on the same quadratic function that we used in the previous videos of this series. Unlike the fixed point iteration method, we successfully found both solutions at x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 5 using the Newton-Raphson method. Despite its fast execution, implementing the Newton-Raphson method can sometimes be challenging because it requires evaluation of the derivative. In the next video, we'll look at secant and modified secant methods that use an approximation of the derivative instead to achieve almost similar efficiency. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.